Praise God. Praise God. Hey, good morning. Thanks for joining me. 40 days. 40 days of miracles. Worship and the Word. Thank you, Lord.
That I will praise.
Praise God.
Oh, and you are the one.
Praise God.
That I will praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
And you are the one.
Hallelujah.
That I.
Praise God.
Forever I'll worship you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Forever I'll worship you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You are the one.
Praise God.
I will praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
Your mercy endureth forever.
Praise God.
And I see that fire in your eyes. Heaven.
We're reading through the miracles. We're in Matthew chapter 9. It's a story of a man that, well, he's sick. He has a disease that somehow affected his hearing. Classical King James would call him mute or deaf, unable to hear. But more tragically, he has been filled with darkness. The Bible speaks of being demon-possessed. And this man is demon-possessed, and he's mute or he's deaf. Unable to hear. There's so much debate and dialogue and a lot of writings about being demon-possessed and having disease. Some people actually teach that all disease is related to demons. Well, there is a relationship in the 40 miracles. But I want to point out to you something as we come to Matthew chapter 9. This is our 11th day reading through miracles, and two of them have to do with sickness and demons. The other nine just deal with sickness. Is there a relationship? Well, clearly in this story, the man is demon-possessed, and he has become deaf. That's quite a relationship. But I want to point out to you, first of all, that many times that we read of signs, wonders, and miracles, Jesus is just dealing with disease and sickness. Be very, very careful. Many years ago, my late wife was diagnosed with cancer. She passed away 7 years later. Regrettably, we both had that experience of saints coming to pray for her that were trying to cast demons out of her. She had no demons in her. She had cancer. We must be clear and we must be careful. Disease is a terrible thing. It is a terrible thing. But not all disease means that somebody has a demon. Now, here in this story, he is deaf and he has a demon. But I want you to study this story carefully with me, because first of all, you will discover that somebody brought this man to Jesus. And that's the significance. Somebody brought this man to Jesus, and he's going to be delivered, and he's going to be set free. Isn't that glorious? Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. One of my very favorite songs is The Enemy's Camp. Oh, wow, boy, I could sing that all day long. God delivers us. God sets us free. We take back what the enemy has stolen. Thanks be unto God. We take back what the enemy has stolen. Don't let darkness control you. Don't let the power of demons rule your life or that of your family or your friends. Remember, the Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Don't put up with it. Take a stand in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But here's what I want you to see. I want you to see that somebody brought him to Jesus. That's right. We bring our family, we bring our friends to the Lord Jesus Christ, and Christ sets him free. The Bible says the people had never seen anything like it before. Boy, that's where I want to live. I want to live and see things that I've never seen before. But that comes from the power of the Lord Jesus Christ working in our lives. Oh, how God loves you. God loves us. May the favor and his grace be upon you. Today, may his face shine upon your path and keep you and protect you and bless you. May his peace be in you. In the name of Jesus, God loves you. We're praying for you. God loves you, and so do we. You be blessed today. You be blessed. Thanks for reading A Miracle Every Day.